पीसी नंबर 421, 5 सेकेंड्स स्टार्ट. सो वेरी वैल्यूएबल सजेशंस हैव बीन मेड बोथ इन रिगार्ड टू द हाउसिंग पॉलिसी ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया एंड ऑल्सो इन रिगार्ड टू प्री फैब्रिकेटेड हाउसिंग इन द कॉन्टेक्स्ट ऑफ दिस हिंदुस्तान हाउसिंग फैक्ट्री. So, I would like to say a few words about the housing policy of the Government of India because many members have touched upon it. So, we undertake housing in two particular ways. One is social housing that we undertake through the state governments, and the other is contract housing, which is undertaken by the Ministry of Housing through the Central Public Works Department. As far as social housing is concerned, I fully agreed with Shri Sapru that housing occupies a very important place in our society. Food, clothing and shelter. We have always been proclaiming that they are the three tenets of our socialistic pattern of society. And I do admit that as far as social housing is concerned, it has not received the same attention as it should have received in our plans. I am not blaming the planners. After all, they have to take the finances of the country into considerable. They have also to take the state resources into consideration. But sir, it is a fact that while the population of the country has been growing and growing very fast. During the last 10 years, there was a rise of over 21%, but in that period, the allocation under housing was brought down from 34% to 15% under the 10th plan. That has been our misfortune, and so the states too. In spite of the fact that the allocations have been lowered, have also not been very active or enthusiastic about the housing programs. There have been lapses, and some of the houses which were built for the industrial workers have been allotted to non-entitled persons. And when the emergency started, even the allocations made for housing in the state plans have been diverted to other projects. They are good projects, important projects, but if we concede that housing gives a man a certain amount of satisfaction, security of life, a home, housing has to receive some priority, if not a very high priority. I have taken this up with the finance minister and the planning minister. I have also been to the life insurance corporation. The life insurance corporation has been very helpful. Now sir, I come for a short while to the housing which is undertaken directly by my ministry. A reference has been made to Delhi. A reference has been made to the unfortunate conditions under which government servants have to live, and the last speaker very rightly remarked that the rents in Delhi are on a very high sight. I have to accept all those premises since I took charge of this ministry. It is nearly a year now. I fully examined the problem from all its aspects. I find, sir, that previously we have been more concerned with paying house rent allowances to our government servants. We have been taking property on lease. We have been requisitioning properties, sometimes paying very heavy rents, and at the same time maintaining those properties which belonged to other people. If all the money that has been paid as rent or as house rent allowances had been diverted to the construction of houses, I am sure that the housing difficulties in Delhi and other parts of the country like Madras, Bombay and Kolkata would not have been so acute. It is a fact that the government servant who has a house has a different outlook. He works in a different way, but nearly 66% of the government servants in Delhi have to take houses on high rents, have to pay very heavy rents, and sometimes they have to live very far away from Delhi. During this year, we have sanctioned housing schemes to the tune of rupees 15 crores. In the last 5 years of this ministry, schemes were sanctioned only to the extent of rupees 7 crores. I am not casting any aspersions. What I am trying to say is this, that I have doubled the program of housing within 1 year as compared to what was done during the last 5 years. I hope that we should be able within the next few years to give a certain amount of satisfaction to the government servants who have to work under very difficult conditions in Delhi. It is not a very happy position in which I am when I am told by the government servants who come to see me that every minister has a house, every member of parliament more or less has been provided with some sort of accommodation. Members of the planning commission, judges of the Supreme Court, senior officers, every one of them has a house, and that too very near to the place of work. But as far as the poor government servants are concerned, most of them have no accommodation.